Well, good morning. Good morning, good morning. This is Prophet West. It's our Tuesday morning. I'm a little tired. I'm just relaxing this morning. Rested okay. I'm a little tired, but I don't feel like moving. Don't feel like doing much at all at this moment. So I'm going to relax, but I can't talk. I can talk about God. I can talk about deliverance. I can talk about healing. I can talk about being brought out. Interesting revelation that I want to give you today. Revelation. And something I saw the other day. It was a basketball game, a simple basketball game. And this brother, good brother from Philadelphia, 76ers, Joel Embiid. After the game was over, this guy cried. He was crying, boo-hooing, crying. And you know, there's some people, social media, whatever, were saying that he was embarrassing himself and he was looking a certain way, but he didn't care. He didn't care. You know, because it hurt. Because his tears was the indication of how much he really cared. His tears showed the sign on how much he wanted it. He wanted it so bad. And when he wasn't able to get it, he was disappointed. He was disappointed. He cried. But there were so many people that were saying, professionals were saying, watch them tears. Watch next year. This brother going to tilt the league. You know, yeah, you was laughing at him. He lost. Embarrassed himself. But those tears were information. Those tears were, when I come back again. These tears not going to flow again. This not going to happen again. No, no, no. And so the revelation that God told me and showed me to reveal to you today is that go ahead and cry, because your victory is in your cry. The Bible says the righteous cry God hears and he will deliver you. As a matter of fact, when you cry out to your Father, he always listens to you. And there's something about those tears. There's something about those tears, because those tears are connected to your soul. Those tears are connected to your heart. And so God said, keep crying, because those tears are serving as the fertilizer of the seeds that you planted in this hour, that you planted in your life. They are fertilizing your seeds. And those tears are going to cause those seeds to become fruit, bear fruit, and grow. Hear me. Many of you, you're crying, you got them tears. And you're crying because you lost. You were crying because you were disappointed. But those tears was the fact that you thought it wouldn't turn out this way. But you said within yourself, you said, I'm going to become my maximum. I'm going to reach out to God. Your tears is getting you into a place where you're talking to God, where you're in a relationship with God. God is making you, getting you closer and closer. And so in those tears, God is filling you up. He's making you full. He's making you full with determination. He's making you full with purpose. The Bible says that there's a time and season for everything and a time for every purpose. Your time and your purpose is now. It's time. It's time to get back on your knees. Just like Joel Embiid, he's going to work when everybody is asleep. He's going to work. He's determined to get back to that place. But this time he's not going to fail. Hear me. Get on your knees and begin to pray those tears, because this time when you get up, you are not going to fail this time. You're going to hit your target this time. You're going to be blessed this time. God's going to get the glory this time. You're going to size up certain things this time. You're going to hit your target this time. You're going to receive everything that God said you are going to receive in this day and time. Not tomorrow, but today. You are blessed today. You're going to receive everything that you ask God for. You ask God for that blessing. You ask God for that healing. You ask for God for that baby. You ask God for that power. You ask God for that touch. And God is going to bring and cause your touch, your power to manifest for such a time as this. And so stay there. Stay there. You're in your last hour. And in that last hour, God wants you to pray.
in that last hour, God, would you keep up your ears open to hear him? And in you hearing him, he's speaking to you. In you hearing him, he's talking to you. In you hearing him, he's telling you exactly what it is that he wants you to do. As a matter of fact, he's building up your character. He's building up your strength. He's building up your fortitude. Quit ye like men and fight. And so some of you, it feels like you're down. See, but God is saying, get up, because greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. God bless you, and keep me in your prayers, and join me in the morning. Join me in the morning at 8:45 Eastern Time on Facebook at Ernest LS, and we'll be releasing a word from the Lord. And I hope you all have a good morning, have a good day, and just remember to keep trusting God. Shut your mind down. Keep believing in him. He's going to see you through. He's going to bring you out. And as my spiritual father always say, Apostle Melvin Mosley, when you're in a time of trouble, when it feels like you're about to drown, and it feels like you're about to go down for that last count, God will take you over the top before he will let you go under. God bless you. Have a good day. Keep me in your prayers. Keep me in your prayers. I'm tired today. We got some good news. I got some good news I'm going to share with you soon. I'm going to keep it, though. I got some good news. Some good news. God bless you. Have a good day.